Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Couples will often curate a gift registry so their guests don't need to spend too much time thinking of an original present to bring along on their wedding day. But for those not willing to abide by the rules, or perhaps who have run out of time, it's all about improvising with what you've got at home. And according to these recipients of wacky wedding gifts collected by Stuff, it's often not worthy creativity. User Piglet Girl wrote on Disboards about the package of paper plates she received from a friend on the eve of her big day. The reason Newlyweds curate a gift registry is so that their guests don't need to think of an original present for the bride and groom. While practical, they're not necessarily a very expensive offering on such a momentous occasion. A friend gave us a framed invitation to her own wedding, which happened about 5 months before, commented another bride to the knot. We got a box of bacon, and I'm talking like 10 kilos of bacon. This guest got it from a meat market and thought, hey, bacon, said a bemused user called Popperoni on Wedding Bee. I divided it up with everyone I knew and their mother, and yet we still have bacon left. Other options included a single saucer for a teacup that had the gifter's names engraved on it, 6 George Foreman grills, a loaf of bread that had already expired, and re-gifted measuring cups. My best friend and her husband got an S&M kit from her unassuming, demure 65-year-old aunt. User Pixie Fatale also wrote on Wedding Bee, a friend gave us a framed invitation to her own wedding, which happened about 5 months before, commented another bride to the knot. The most confusing of contributions came in the form of a big black glass monkey sculpture from a group of one man's friends. Afterwards, one of the wives pulled me aside, apologized for such a strange gift, said that they're never letting the boys go shopping on their own again, and that we were welcome to return it. User Jen Angeles wrote on Wedding Bee. Popular backup choices that required no thought whatsoever were a bag of used spices, a Jesus nightlight, and a dog leash when the couple didn't even own a pet. The lesson learned by many of the newlyweds appeared to be just accepting whatever gifts came their way, and returning those they could.